said, do you wanna play? Do you wanna play?
What a wicked game to play. You never felt this way. What a wicked thing to do. So make me dream of you. What a wicked thing to say. You never felt this way. What a wicked thing to do. To make me dream of you. No, I don't wanna fall in love. No, I don't wanna fall in love.
We always hear about moderation with eating. What about moderation in relationships? What about fraud-oration? Moderation to the frauds. Not everybody's all good. Not everybody's all bad. But just because they ain't all bad don't mean we can only focus on what's good, right? So we gotta protect ourselves. So I'm trying this new thing where if I don't trust you, you are not my enemy. You're your own damn enemy. Because I look at it like this. It's hard to know people who don't know themselves. So I don't really blame you for not being trustworthy. You see, people that switch lanes and their loyalties daily, they'll talk about you to somebody and then they'll talk about the person they just talked about you to. They don't know themselves. So they damn sure don't know how they really feel about you. They're just, their mouth moves depending on who they're around and talks to. You know what I'm saying? So this is my new thing. I keep you at arm's length. If you're iffy, I keep you 50-50. I don't hate you, I don't love you. We can be cool, but that don't mean I gotta be a fool. You stay at arm's length. Give it a little smile. Pretend I care about how you doing. Hi. Keep it motherfucking moving.
I'm sorry. I don't know you anymore. What?
I don't know you. Why are you talking to me? I don't know you. Who are you? I don't know you.
You see, the minute we broke up, it's like on a homepage, I completely refresh. I clear my cache. The second we break up, I turn into a new person. I'm not even who you thought I was anymore. That didn't even happen. My register cleared. I was born again. The moment we broke up, I got back together with myself, and I don't know who you think you're talking to. I got my lips done, my eyebrows raised, I'm a new bitch. What the fuck are you doing? Who are you talking to? I don't even roll my hair the way I used to. I don't even see my fingers. They're skinnier now. I don't know you. Who are you talking to? Have a new car, too. Got rid of everything that reminded me of you. My name is now Sarah, and I live in Hawaii.
Whether you're gay or straight, Christian or Muslim, atheist or agnostic, no matter what race you are, whether you're in America or not in America, whether you're a hamburger person or a pizza person, whether you drink through a straw or just take the whole lid off and drink the freaking thing, whether you cuss like a sailor or pray like a Baptist, whether you're suffering from mental illness, whether you're around a bunch of people or you feel alone, or both. Whether you're smiling right now, or sad. Whether you have on Louis Vuittons, or you're hopping around like a motherfucking frog. Whether you're an asshole, or a whole ass. Whether it's July 4th, or any other day of the freaking year. Happy life.
Chris Crocker took to YouTube to defend Britney Spears, who was going through some tough times. Now Crocker has turned his initial exposure into acting work, has just released an album that can be found on iTunes.
Well, I was walking through the Kmart in my short shorts, and this lady walked by me and she said, well, I ain't never in my life. And she was obviously talking about them old long legs hanging out these short shorts, and I looked at her and I said, well, if you ain't never, you never will. Well, boy, I told her straight, you don't need to be commenting on what I'm wearing, folks. If you don't like what you see out in public when I'm out here wearing these old Daisy Dukes. What, you think a Duke can't wear a Daisy? Just because I'm a boy don't mean I can't have no sexy legs. My legs are sexy. Well, they're hotter than fireballs. People down in the South try to act like they're just so innocent, like you ain't never seen a man in the shorts. Ain't you ever been to the beach? Ain't you ever been to the beach? So y'all women can dress all sexy and stuff, but y'all ain't never seen a man showing off his long, long, sexy granddaddy long legs. I'll tell you one thing, and I'll tell it to you good. All that snooty ain't gonna stop this booty from bootin' tootin'.
I find it oddly funny anytime you talk about any kind of racism or homophobia in the South, all these Southern people jump up in the air and say, well, we're not all like that. Well, you tell me when in the hell I said you all were like that. You can't tell me. You can't tell me my experience as a gay person in the South. You can't tell me what I've lived. You can't tell me what I've lived a bit more than a dog in a shoe house. You can't tell me what I've lived a bit more than a mole in a skin house hole. You need to shut your mouth and learn to listen what other people have lived through. Just because you ain't like that don't mean you can tell me what the hell I've lived through, boys and girls. Okay? It's time we get honest about what's going on in our backyards down here in the South. You know, we think of sipping on a mint julep and a pretty nature and all this good old stuff. But let's get real. If you ain't a straight white person, life's a little bit different down here, honey. And you won't know that unless you are of the difference. So listen up and shut up with your guilty conscience. I'll tell you one thing right now, and I'll tell it to you good. Family is more than a last name. Family is more than blood. Family is more than seeing each other on Christmas time. Family is more than seeing each other once every 3 months when it's convenient. And I'll tell you one thing right now. We always put so much emphasis. We put so much emphasis on family's everything. It's all you got in the world. Well, Lord of mercy, if that's all I got, I ain't got much. Because I'll tell you right now, a lot of family will run your name through the mud quicker than a stranger will. Oh, did you hear what so-and-so's doing? Lord, you see his Facebook? Lord, let me show that to so-and-so. Don't ever call and see how you're doing. But boy, I watch my Facebook videos quicker than tic-tac-toe. I guess they think, well, I don't ever call him, so I might as well watch his videos and see what he's up to. Boy, if that's family, my name's Sarah, and I'm from Hawaii. And then they wonder why, when they finally do call you, when it's convenient, why you don't jump up in the air and click your heels and put on your Sunday's best to see them. I don't know you! So today I was sitting in a waiting room next to a gentleman. And on the news, on the TV, on the screen, they were talking about, you know, gay pride and, you know, how it's been a year, you know, that marriage equality has been around. And this man next to me goes, Lord, that's a shame, isn't it? And see, he said this to me in comfortability, because when I go around in this town, I kind of look like this sometimes. So anyways, like I was saying, I turned to him and I said, it is a shame, isn't it? He says, yeah, man, I just don't understand the world. I said, I know what you mean. It's a shame it took so long. Me and my husband, we just thought it'd never happen. He goes, oh, is that right? And I shut that shit down right there, honey. It's just a fact. People will talk shit when they just don't know who they're talking to. Which is why anytime you hear some shit like that, speak on up and shut them on up.
I tell you what, sometimes I feel like going gay. Told my wife she looked good today in a dress, because she asked me, she said, do I look good? And I said, well, yeah. She said, no, I don't. And I said, the hell are you talking about? She said, if I did, you'd say, well, Lord, yeah, you do. And I said, well, that might be true, but I just want you to feel good. Even when you don't look good, I want you to feel good. She said, so you're saying I don't look good? I said, what in the tarnation, what in the hell are you trying to start up an argument for? Lord have mercy, God. Lord have mercy, God. I ain't never in my life heard such bull. And she said, well, forget it then, and slammed the door. She's been in there since days of our lives went off. I swear sometimes I think about trying out a man. Maybe a man and woman's only supposed to connect in one way. If you know what I mean. I'd rather shoot some pool with a dude at this point.
A little hater tot. Yeah, I call my haters hater tots. It's like a tater tot, but a hater tot. I have to give them a cute little name. You know, because their spirit and their attitude's not cute, so I gotta call them something cute. Little hater tot. Left me a comment and said, do you have a life outside of posting Instagram and Facebook videos? And I said, well, sweetie, when you have an HBO documentary on your life, when you have albums on iTunes, when you have an online clothing store, when you've been in multiple TV shows and in a movie, I'll answer your question. But until then, if you really wanted to answer, you'd get to Googling. instead of typing stupid shit.
Have a wonderful day. Kisses.
Okay, believe it or not, I've never tried the Magnum ice cream, so this is my first time trying it. I got the caramel one, the double caramel. Feel like I'm sliding down a stripper pole. Feel like I need to be tipping this. It's making me feel a little naughty. Gotta lick the stick clean. That shit good. Sterling was standing outside selling CDs, was reported to police for supposedly pulling out a gun in public. Supposedly. Sterling was held down by two police officers, both bearing arms, held down on the ground, and then shot 6 times and killed. To the people that want to say the police are just here to protect us, to the people that want to say the police were just doing their job, half of you are the same people who defend the rights to bear arms. So if you want to make a big deal of the fact they found a gun in his pocket, get real about the fact that the way they handled it was cold-blooded, uncalled for, cruel, and inexcusable. A life was lost. A father was lost. The truth is that it's not that there's more violence, there's more cameras. Having a badge doesn't mean you get to play God. Black Lives Matter. After what happened in Orlando at Pulse, you started to see a lot of Gay Lives Matter hashtags and Trans Lives Matter hashtags. And after certain tragedies that happen, such as the one today with Sterling, you see Black Lives Matter. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, people start responding with All Lives Matter. It's like that's their automatic defense to everything that happens to minority groups is All Lives Matter. We all know that all of our lives matter. The point of a hashtag is to say to the public, to the police, to terrorists, to assholes of the world, that the lives of these minority groups do matter and that we do care about their lives. So when you say all lives matter, it's a direct slap in the face and you're undermining the real issue. I don't think you're blind to the problem. I think you're a part of the problem. If you really believe all of our lives matter, why do you resist when we point out that one group's does? You would rather argue over a hashtag? I'm gonna admit it. I eat too much unhealthy shit. I just do. My mouth opens and I'm like, where's the food? But there's a reason for that. People stress me the fuck out. The world stresses me the fuck out. When I'm stressing out, I open my mouth. Instead of cutting a bitch, I cut a slice. Food keeps me peaceful. Next time someone tells you to eat healthy or quit eating so much, say, well, quit pissing me off so damn much, and I might. If you wasn't getting on my nerves, I wouldn't be gaining these curves. If I had a superpower, it would be to get stupid people to realize they're being stupid, and then to realize they're not really stupid, they're choosing to be stupid. Like, if I'm presenting to you facts that racism is still very alive and rampant, rampant, I can't even speak, and I'm talking about stupid people. If I could just get people to realize plain as day facts without having to have this long, long, drawn out back and forth, I would feel like I was accomplishing something. But I swear to God, some people are stuck in the muds. They just can't move forward. Guess we'll have to leave them behind where they want to be. I was thinking to myself, I was like, you know, I see all of our differences of opinions, you know, our differences are so plain to see.
But what's the one thing that we all have in common? What's the one thing that no person can disagree with in the world, no matter who you are? What's the one thing we can all agree on? We all want to be loved and accepted for who we are. We all have that want, but we don't all know how to give that in return to other people. If we all knew how to give what we want, that's the simplest, most pure, true thing that you can do. And if you don't understand where maybe someone's coming from, just listen. Because the refusal to hear someone else's truth is actually a refusal to yourself to allow new information in. How can we understand one another when the only thing we're willing to understand is what we already think?
I'm watching what's happening going on in Dallas right now. I'm trying to come up with something inspirational to say to bring us all together, but honestly, I don't know what to say anymore. People have their mind made up that we're each other's enemies. We don't know how to stand together. Everyone's so defensive. Everyone's pointing fingers and guns. Some people are arguing, saying like, well, if Black Lives Matter, what about the cops' lives? And it's like, of course those cops' lives matter. The point of Black Lives Matter was never to say that's the only lives that matter, people. Cops who are here to protect us and protect us all equally, thank you. Thank you. Black Lives Never has never been about being against all cops. It's about people who abuse their power. Violence is never the answer. United we stand, divided we fall. And we need to remember that now.
I thought everyone in the world could use a smile right now, so I'm going to tell you the funniest joke that I have ever heard in my entire life. I mean, if this don't make you laugh, I mean, why did Adele cross the road? So she can say hello from the other side. Funny, but there's no way I'll need to laugh, so
whatever it takes, right, to get through the day.
I have a challenge for everyone that says all lives matter when they hear Black Lives Matter. Make it to the end of this video before you comment. How about that? We'll see if they did. You know they won't. It would be like me showing up to a breast cancer fundraiser and saying, but what about all the other cancers? It would be like me showing up to the doctor's office with my knee broken and him saying, well, all your bones matter. Yeah, but right now we need to fix this right here. Saying all lives matter is essentially saying that the sky is blue. You're not saying anything we don't know. It's the fact that with all of the police brutality specifically being in larger numbers towards black lives, if you are not black, you do not know how that feels. I don't know how that feels. But you have a choice to either imagine that or to simply say, well, I don't encounter it, so it doesn't exist. Black Lives Matter is about anti-brutality from police towards black lives and anti-brutality towards anyone. And one last time, Black Lives Matter is not anti-police. Black Lives Matter is anti-police killing black lives. People will use anything to push their own agenda. And I don't know how they can't see that it's racist to not just agree that Black Lives Matter. But when you're really that stupid to believe that a group of people who are fighting for equality are anti-police lives, you're dense. You're dense. It's about anti-brutality to everyone. We all know that all lives matter. The sky is also blue. I'm a gay person. Gay lives matter, trans lives matter, people in my community who are brutalized all the time for being who they are. And that's a group that I closely stand with because I'm a part of it. But I don't have to be black to see why the movement is important. All lives matter, but not everyone is at the same risk. All lives matter, which is why Black Lives Matter.
Let me tell you something, honey. When people piss me off, I get to making my fuck you sandwich. That's right. Okay?
I get my little piece of bread with cheese on it. Just a little bit of mayonnaise on there. Enough for a mouse. Okay, slather that on there. Okay, here comes the FU part. This is for all that stress they've been putting on me. Running that mouth and shit. Get you some chips. Put your hand on your hip. Say to hell with it. What I think about all that bull.